Hi again, everyone. Thanks for joining us again today. We're going to do some music from the 1960s and do some reminiscence about the 60s. So let's get started with our hellos. Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care? What the heck do we care? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care now? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care? What the heck do we care? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. What the heck do we care now? If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. Baked a cake, baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How you do, how you do, how you do? Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band, the grandest band in the land. Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band. It's about the welcome mat for you. Now I don't know where you came from, cause I don't know where you've been. But it really doesn't matter, grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake, baked a cake, baked a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. How you do, how you do, how you do? How you do, how you do, how you do?
All right, 1960s. Fads of the 1960s. The first one that they have listed here is afros. Everyone had an afro. It was the hairdo of choice. The bigger, the better. And even the girls had afros. I don't think I can physically make my hair into an afro. I think that's impossible. So I'm glad I missed out on that one. All right, let's start off with some Van Morrison here. Hey, where did we go? Days when the rains came. Down in a hollow, laying a new game. Tapping and a running, hey, hey, skipping and a jumping. In the misty morning fog with our hearts thumping at you. A brown eyed girl. You, my brown eyed girl. Do you remember when we used to sing shalala? Whatever happened to Tuesday is so slow. Going down to the old mine with a transistor radio. Standing in the sunlight laughing, hide behind the rainbow's wall. Slipping and sliding all along the waterfall with you. My brown-eyed girl. To sing sha la 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 da sha la 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 da brown eyed girl. So hard to find my way now that I'm on my own. I saw you just the other day, my, how you had grown. Cast my memory back there, Lord. Sometimes I'm overcome. Making love in the green, green grass, hey, behind the stadium with you. My brown-eyed girl.
right. Oops, I'm sorry. All right, the next thing they have on here, balsa wood airplanes. Model planes made from balsa wood. Kids would make them and fly them just like paper airplanes, but they would fly better. Companies stopped making them because kids were sniffing the glue used to make the planes. Which I don't think they stopped making them. They just stopped including the glue, because I'm pretty sure I had them too. Or my brothers did. I didn't. My brothers did. I do know that one of my friends had a banana seat on her bike, though. That was because it was her mom's when she was a kid. So, banana seats, the long bike seats that had the curved back. I don't know why they were so popular. Were they more comfortable? I don't know. And then Barbie dolls in 1965. $100 million of Barbie merchandise was sold. Barbie was the one to make the Mattel the biggest toy company in the world. They were created by Ruth and Elliot Handler, the owners of Mattel. After watching their daughter play with paper dolls, realizing there weren't any three-dimensional dolls to play with and dress, Barbie was named after their daughter for the idea. Aw, that's kind of cute. My mom also got me paper dolls to play with and dress. I think she liked to maybe relive her youth with me. My mom was a teenager in the 60s, so. All right. How about the foundations? Build me up, Buttercup. That was I
for some reason, my nephew's favorite song when he was about 2. He loved to sing that song. All right, Beatlemania was a fad in the 60s. Of course it was. Rabid Beatle fans suffered from Beatlemania. People would faint at their concerts and even just from seeing them perform on TV. Were any of you Beatlemania crazy? Let's see if we can find a Beatles song here. How about With a Little Help from My Friends? What would you think if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song, and I'll try not to sing out of key. Ooh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. What do I do when my love is away? Does it worry you to be alone? How do I feel at the end of the day? Are you sad because you're on your own? Ooh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? Need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. Would you believe in love at first sight? Yes, I'm certain it happens all the time. What do you see when you turn up the light? I can't tell cause I know that it's mine. Ooh, I get by with a little help from my friend. Get high with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? I want somebody to love. Do you need anybody? I need somebody to love. Could it be anybody? Somebody to love. Ooh, I get by with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I'm gonna try with a little help from my friends. Oh, the Beatles. All right. Bell Bottoms, which came back for a little while in like the 2000s. But not quite to the extent that they were in the 70s, I don't think. So, the wide leg pants derived from Navy style uniforms and became very popular with the young in the 1960s. Elvis Presley, Sonny and Cher, they both helped make bell bottoms a fashion statement for hippies and the counterculture audience. They were typically made of denim until they were produced with corduroy and polyester so they could be worn in any situation. Bell bottoms were still popular in the 1970s during the disco years, and even again in the 90s when the Gen X crowd started wearing them to be cool too. All right, black lights. In the late 60s, black lights put things into a new perspective, adding a fluorescent glow to the room. White shirts and teeth would light up in the room with their bright white glow. Black lights would reveal secret symbols or slogans on posters located in the college dorm rooms. These lights also appeared in nightclubs and theater productions around the country, creating a surreal atmosphere. Coupled with a strobe light, black lights created a disorienting purple haze. Nowadays, you can still find black lights in nightclubs. There are more fluorescent materials on the market, paints, dyes, and clothes, markers that come to life with the existence of a black light. We also played with these when I was a child. So, I guess I maybe am more of a 60s kid than I realized. Or maybe my parents just really enjoyed the fads of the 60s, huh? All right, we'll slow it down here.
Elvis's Can't Help Falling in Love. What else did we play with and follow in the 60s? The Bouffant Hairdo, a trend launched first by Lady Jackie Kennedy. It was a difficult style to wear, time-consuming to achieve, and required a great number of tools to concoct. It came to an end in around 1964 after the assassination of Kennedy. One not so positive is fallout shelters. With the threat of nuclear war on the horizon, some Americans looked for ways to protect themselves from horrible destruction. They decided upon bomb-proof fallout shelters. Most looked like basic units providing space only for necessities, which were generally only 2 weeks' supplies, while others looked like small guest houses equipped with pool tables, paintings, and wine cellars. Fancy. The fallout shelter fad reached its peak in the early 60s as the Cuban Missile Crisis loomed, but it waned in the 70s as various treaties were signed, calming apocalyptic fears. Every decade had something kind of terrible, didn't it? I guess this is the tough time of the 20s, huh? All right, more fun one, go-go boots. In 1965... by Andre Carregas, a leading French fashion designer. I'm sorry, I don't think I said that right at all.
worn by women from Los Angeles to New York at nightclubs all over. Nancy Sinatra also topped the charts with These Boots Are Made for Walkin', established her as the poster child for go-go boots. I do know that song, but I'm not going to sing it for you because I can't pull it off because I can't do that cool bass line. Which is so, that's the song. That's what makes the song, right? All right, one last one before I do another song. Granny glasses, those tiny little glasses. Once worn as a fashion statement of vibrant youth, also known as Ben Franklin glasses, first appeared in the 1960s in California. They were worn by John Lennon and Roger McGinn. Within about 2 years, the granny glasses had died out and became undecidedly cool. All right. What's next here? How about the monkeys? I could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings. The 6 o'clock alarm would never ring, but it rings and I rise, wipe the sleep out of my eyes. My shaving razor's cold and it stings. Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? You once thought of me as a white knight on his. Now you know how happy I can be. And our good time starts and ends without a dollar one to spend. But how much, baby, do we really need? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? Cheer up, sleepy Jean. Oh, what can it mean to a daydream believer and a homecoming queen? I learned that one just like 2 days ago, so I don't think it's quite right, but I'll work on it. All right, how about Georgia on My Mind? Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through, just that old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Georgia on my mind. Georgia, Georgia, song of you comes as sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines.
other arms reach out to me. Other eyes smile tenderly. Still in peaceful dreams I see the road leads back to you. Georgia, Georgia, no peace I find. Just that old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind. Just that old sweet song keeps Georgia on my mind.
All right, hair ironing. Once the bouffant had begun to look old, young girls in the northeastern states staged a revolt, taking up hot irons and ironed their hair dead straight. The ironed tresses lasted about an hour, and this fad diminished in the 70s, followed by less dangerous styles. Literally, a clothes iron on their hair. Their poor hair. That sounds terrible. Lava lamps. Black lights, lava lamps, strobe lights. Keeping things psychedelic in the 60s, right? Love beads. I'm not too familiar with this one, except that I think that, like, John Lennon wore them and at some point. Maybe. Maybe I'm wrong. Love beads came in a variety of patterns and were given as gifts between friends or made by the person wearing them. They were worn around the neck and wrist and were very colorful. They could be purchased in a store or could be made. They were a very common sign of friendship in the 60s and 70s. And then here began the era of women's liberation with miniskirts. They achieved their height of their popularity around 1967. By that point, virtually every young woman was wearing one, most as a sign of rebellion. Demure was out and letting it all hang out was in. And the new woman demanded that the world appreciate her on her own terms. Mood rings. The rings that changed colors when your mood changed. Ouija boards because of the movie The Exorcist. And then platform shoes. I wonder how many of you are in platform shoes. They were more popular in the 70s, though they started in the 60s, so I can imagine how many twisted or broken ankles were caused by platform shoes. I don't think I would have been brave enough to wear them, but that's just me. All right. How about I want to hold your hand? Thank you.
classic, right? A classic. All right, let's finish up our list here. What else do we have? Ricky Tiki stickers, the colorful flower stickers, sticking on everything from cars, wastebaskets, walls, windows, and more. And I don't know this one. Scully is a street game where the course is painted or chalked on concrete grounds. The object was to go from the starting line to each of the numbered boxes, then back down in the beginning by flicking your bottle caps on the course. Sea monkeys. I did have sea monkeys. I didn't know they were, like, I learned more about them now today researching fads from the 60s, and I knew about them when I was a kid. But in 1957, this gentleman, Harold von Braunhut, discovered a true freak of nature and recognized its potential to become one of the greatest marketing opportunities in history. After watching the creature known as the Artemios, a relative to the brine shrimp, out of water, it would appear dead, and once introduced back into the water, it would mysteriously come back to life without any suffered ill effects. He then began to sell them through mail order in the 1960s, packaging them in a box labeled Instant Life, and they were sold for 49 cents through comic book advertisements. They kept growing, and now 40 years later, they are still charming kids everywhere. This is true. I will probably get some for my son, too, instead of a fish. Slogan buttons became popular in the 60s. It became a true fad status. The typical hippie backpack was bristled with them. The buttons gave voice to many sentiments, declarations, most of which were political. All right. This is another one I was not familiar with. Slot cars. Before the era of video games, young boys throughout the world shared another obsession, the slot car. It's an electric toy racing car that ran on grooved track. Slot racing cars were part of the British culture, but it wasn't until it hit the United States in 1965 that its popularity really took off. Many fans built their own cars and constructed their own tracks. By 1967, the slot car had been sidelined in this high-tech world that flashier, more powerful toys would rule the world. And then, of course, smiley faces. Super balls are still around today. So many great toys came out of the 60s. Surfing with the Beach Boys. The Twist made Chubby Checker made his dance style popular when he appeared on American Bandstand in the early 60s. It originated in a small New York club called the Peppermint Lounge in 1961. The dance was featured in a few films in the early 60s, but faded when other dances such as the Mashed Potato and the Watusi, I hope I got that right, sorry guys, were introduced to TV shows and movies. I don't know what the Watusi is. Tie-dye t-shirts, troll dolls, turtlenecks, this list just keeps on going. But we'll do a couple more songs and then we'll call it a day. All right, we'll do a Roger Miller. We'll switch it up a little bit. So this is from the 60s. King of the Road. Thank you. sense. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing room pass. And ain't got a 4-bedroom mama. One more, we'll call it a day. How about we'll do another country one? I don't do a lot of country music, which is kind of strange because I feel like I know a lot of country music, so we'll do some more country music. Ring of Fire. As always, if you have requests or suggestions or don't do that one again, that was terrible, let me know. I realized like last night in the middle of the night that I never gave you my email address, so that's probably the easiest way to contact me right now, and it is tamano@wesleylife.org. So T-A-M as in man, A-N as in O, no, @wesleylife.org. So I'll take all of the feedback you have. I want to do what you want to hear. I want to learn new songs and, you know, do anything that's meaningful to you. So always, always, always feel free to let me know what you like and what you don't like. I can take it, I promise. So anyway, I hope you have enjoyed recalling the 60s with me. Though I've learned a couple things, and I can't wait to hear those stories from you, because I bet you have some great ones. The 60s were kind of a crazy time. So anyway, I hope you're all well, and I will see you again soon. Take care.